I've handed in quests.
I need to spam... I need to get back in the habit of spamming recuperate, because I keep having running out of hit points between fights, remembering, like, oh yeah, I don't have first aid like I used to. I need to actually use the thing that gives me hit points back, or I'm going to have downtime.
There was something in the music that reminded me of my ringtone, so I looked over and I'm like, oh wait, no, my phone's not ringing or anything. Like this one time where I was listening to my favorite Metroid Prime theme, and I kept thinking that my mother was yelling something from downstairs.
In the Metroid theme?
Well, in Metroid Prime 2 Echoes, there's like a weird sound effect that sounds exactly like her when she's raising her voice to yell at someone.
And it is very, very specific, and I will hear it like from a distance over Skype and just be like,
But it's in the song, so it's my favorite song. And partway through it, I get like a chill, like, oh gosh, she's after me. And then I realize it's in the soundtrack.
What a weird concept.
It's horrible.
Nothing quite like mistaking a sound, though.
Yep.
I remember being up super late. I would have the window directly behind my computer monitor would be open usually at night because it gets hot in California and everything, and you try to vent air and everything. And I'd be playing games way too late, like way too late sometimes, and I would just hear a loud bang. And the thing is, it's so quiet at night that anything would seem loud, and I would, at some point, like, I would, like, think that, like, was there a fucking gunshot outside my house? It was the mailman throwing, or it was the newspaper guy, he was just throwing newspapers, and I thought it was a gunshot, because of how loud it seemed compared to how quiet it was. And, like, that's what happened to, that was actually a plot point recently in Better Call Saul, is that there was someone who kept thinking someone was shooting guns outside their house, but it turned out to be the mailman in the morning. And it's just such a loud bang.
That's a really pretty phoenix too. Purple one.
Yep. So you do a quest here and then the Flightmaster spawns. That's a weird thing I've never seen before.
It's good. Well, it's because we fixed the,
Yeah, we fixed the Flightmaster. It's just I've never seen a Flightmaster spawn in this game before.
Specifically the Flightmaster. Not the copter, just the guy.
Yeah,
where's Lucky Wilhelm?
Can you think of any other situation in this game where that happened? Where the Flightmaster didn't exist and then you make him exist?
Coming up with blanks there, but...
Yeah.
They start doing it more often. In this game, honestly.
So we need to kill Dread Sabers, Sandhorn Rhinos, and what's the other quest I have down there? Oh, shot apple on Lucky Willem's head.
Yeah, you might as well do that one. It takes a couple of tries.
So where is Willem? Hi, you're a tall one. Is it?
He's
one of the
like
birds?
Right there. Like you're very close.
Let's see. What do I do here? Oh, right. I have a gun in my inventory. Oh no! Not the stash, now I'm asymmetrical.
I always forget just how good the music in World of Warcraft is. And then, like,
never
a
hear
specific
it.
Song will pop up. Yeah, usually it's turned down a fair amount.
Oh, Willem is that little...
How far away do you wander
there.
And Shell live? Basically other sides of the planet.
Woohoo! Got it one try.
Yes. Well,
Shell just
no.
did the quest for me.
Oh, that's nice.
I just got shown up by Shell where I was doing multiple shots and it wasn't working, and she just walked up and did it one try, and I got credit
nice.
For it.
But yeah, Shell and I are 6 hours away. Keith, I'm in Boston. Keith is in California. So
nailed it.
Well, I mean, if we move out, it won't be so bad. Gotta get there. The problem is, like, I don't want to move, like, the day or, like, too close to any major release, because it's just like, well, that's out. But...
60 game animals. This is something you're going to go through the entire zone doing.
You guys want to come to where I am? I've got the Dread Sabers and the Shardhorn Rhinos, and they're all in, like, a big group.
Almost there. Chat says they find it funny that two people left Spool and Array. I mean, a lot of people left Rooster Teeth. Because they're a giant company.
Yeah.
I mean, even in that topic, like, Joel just left, the other person from Funhouse, which is right there with Spool, but, Like, the guy that ran their movie podcast left. People just leave because it's just a company, and people go on to do other things with their lives.
Yep. It's just hard to think of them.
I need a target.
Leaving, because for the most part they've been there since the beginning.
Who?
So like, well, I mean, like Joel. Joel's been there for all of Funhouse before Funhouse was a Funhouse.
Yeah.
And Spool's been around obviously since the inception of Funhouse, but also like for quite some time as part of the previous whatever that was, right? Yeah, he was their intern for a while. And hence the joke. But since the internet has kind of such a short memory because it's been such a short existence, it's hard to think of anybody leaving.
Oh yeah.
So like
people think everyone's gonna be around forever for everything.
Like the concept of John Jafari leaving Game Grumps is just like,
even though he'd been there for less than a year.
Yeah. But it was just such an uncomfortable concept for people because
you mean this thing where you play video games and make videos every day, you might stop? And like it was like it blew people's minds. Although a lot of those people are actually 13 years old. So like that was like 10% of their lifespan so far. It's like, holy shit, this is my hero.
Yeah, and considering you can only remember maybe like 6 of those years.
Oh yeah, because you don't remember being a little kid anymore. So it's like it's seriously like 20% of your life as you know it at that point, and one of your heroes leaves your favorite YouTube channel as a kid.
Yeah, just boom, gone.
What really blows my mind about how young a lot of people on YouTube are is when I see comments where they say stuff like this game's nostalgic. It's from my childhood, and it's a game that like came out like 8 years ago. And I'm like, oh yeah, that game from a little while ago. And it's like, oh, you were a baby. Oh no.
Oh, somebody did that with a game that came out in 2011. And I was just like, just Borderlands. Somebody said that like they played this when they were like 4, and I was just like.
First of all, that person's watching your stream as an 11-year-old then. What the fuck?
Well, I mean, kids these days are using the internet. Younger.
Well, I got a lot of people from Scrap Mechanic that are, like, younger audiences.
Yeah.
Which is why you should watch your language.
No. Nope.
Because,
I'm not pandering to kids, Shell. I tried. I regretted it.
Well, I'm glad at least you taper... I mean, it off around me. I know that you haven't been effing your way through this entire episode.
I mostly swear during Scrap Mechanic because dumb things are happening.
Oh, there's tiny rhinos.
Chat, the main Rooster Teeth person that's named Joel is a very different person than the one from Funhouse.
Yes.
Once someone...
We've killed all of them. This
one looks
bleak.
Like they're in their 20s, and the other one is someone who is a kind of failed actor in their 40s, I want to say. Who played Caboose on Red vs. Blue.
Well, I guess let's just start killing random animals until the saber-tooth leopards.
Yeah, there's just not animals around here. I had someone tell me that I should restructure my content because clearly Funhouse knows what they're doing. Look how they got such a big channel so fast. And I just had to explain to them that, like, they're part of Rooster Teeth, which means they get... Yeah, it's a double pre-existing fan base. It's just like when Game Grumps spawned and they're like, we got JonTron and we get Aaron audiences in one channel. And that's why it quickly grew past JonTron's channel size. Like, Funhouse was literally like, hey, let's take fans of Rooster Teeth and fans of whatever Funhouse was called before Funhouse and mix them into one channel and just get instant success for free, basically.
Yeah.
They have to earn the part where they keep them around afterwards, but like that, they just get to skip to the part where they already have an audience.
It actually fascinates me how much Game Grumps specifically has changed the field of Let's Play, because before them, like duo collab channels generally didn't exist.
No, not really. Like, I mean, we existed.
They were there,
and
but
it wasn't working.
Yeah.
But like I started doing the Game Grumps thing a year before Game Grumps did it, and no one cared.
Yes.
But if you have your pre-existing audience, you can just make a market, and then suddenly change everything.
You can do anything. I was having a conversation with my mother, because every once in a while she will like challenge me on like, oh, you know, someday you'll find something better to do, or you'll realize you failed and like move on, and I'm like, stop saying that. Like, I know you're supportive of, like, what I'm doing, but it's just annoying, because it's just like, no, I'm pretty well...
She's waiting for you to give up on being a member of a band, basically.
Yeah. Except for, like, I have charts and graphs showing just how much my income has grown over the past year, so it's like, I'm pretty okay with this. It's low now, but it'll be nice next year.
It's been fun growing up in a time period where everyone we know just had their economically, like, things just worked out for them in many cases.
Yes.
A lot of them don't have college degrees, and they just got jobs, and it's no big deal, and they just, they've been able to support themselves, like, no big, like, straight out of high school, and they could pay rent and
everything. Totally fair. All of my relatives on my dad's side have, like, don't have degrees and, like, low-paying jobs and are poor and fat and multiple other issues.
A large amount of my family has successful jobs where they can pay rent and go on vacations and have a good time, do all these things, and none of them have, like, college degrees, and they just stumbled into a job and everything worked out for them. And I'm like, I got a degree and I still can't find jobs that pay as well as the ones you got straight out of high school with no degree, as far as, like how much it pays versus how much it costs to make things work.
I mean, granted, the degrees that Wander and I had gotten, I mean, they don't guarantee
useless to
you
begin
anything
with.
Because, I mean...
We should go back and see if those rhinos have respawned.
The companies say, you know, it'd be nice if you have a degree, but if you have a, you know, smashing portfolio, they're going to be like, yeah, we'll hire you. But now it's, you know, 3 years of experience, must have shipped one game.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, there's nothing quite like a low-level art position that requires multiple years in working in AAA already. It's just like...
That's been my entire experience trying to get a job as a geologist, is every single job position wants you to have several years of experience and calls it entry-level. I'm like, do you know what those words mean?
Yeah, and the thing too is, I mean, so many jobs now also require that you be a local on top of that. I mean, the population of the United States is what, grown by a third or more since our parents' time, so...
Oh yeah, Keith, remember how I flew out for an interview and, like, you know, visited you and stuff?
Oh yeah, we got to meet in person because you visited me locally.
Now that company requires that you be local.
Yes. But they also didn't hire anybody from that
the entire thing?
Yeah.
I think they may have just gotten you slave labor to, like, work things out
it was
for free.
A trick. They made a fake job fair to playtest their game.
Yep.
That's gross and kind of illegal, probably.
That is,
well, they did pay you, right?
Yeah, I got paid.
Oh, okay. It's totally legal then, at least.
That's why it's legal, but...
Gross. Wow.
Yeah,
they pretended they were going to hire people so they could get free playtesting. That,
but
I guarantee you that's what that was.
Yeah, I had to fly out there too, so it cost me money.
That's
I'm like, I'm okay
super
with it
gross.
Because I got to spend a week hanging out with, you know, you guys, but...
But so gross.
Oh yeah, very, very gross. And obviously never doing that again for multiple reasons.
Also fucking with our expectations, because we're all thinking about this new life that's in these different conditions now. Because totally gonna happen, right? And then none of it happens. Because then they probably never planned on having it happen. It's totally like having someone date you because they want free tickets to the concert coming up. It's exactly what it's like. Like, making you think that the next year of your life's going to be different, potentially, with this relationship, and they were actually just trying to get you to pay for them to go to the show.
I'm getting some, like, repressed memories feeling from this.
A little bit.
Why?
Did this actually happen to you?
Kind of. I think I had I'm fairly convinced at this point that I had a girlfriend that stuck around longer than she wanted to because she wanted to go into a show for free.
Oh,
wow.
But it wasn't
like
the beginning, it was like a year into it.
The free dinners, the attention,
this isn't long term. Let's go to a different quest. Oh wait, there's more Dread Sabers elsewhere.
Let's go to a different topic.
No, I want to finish this quest, and so I'm trying to look at the map and, like, go elsewhere.
I still need 5 Dread Sabers, but they don't seem to show
follow
up.
Follow me. There's more, there's,
oh, there
like, more
spawn.
Sets of Dread Sabers. Yeah, they're spread out all over
there
the place.
There it is.
In fact, apparently there's whole slews of areas for multiple of these. I'll stop when I find one.
I just realized that some of those
looks like people have been busy, though.
Wandering around, it reminds me of Jumanji. I haven't seen Jumanji in ages.
Yeah, neither have I.
So it totally fucked my expectations for the job market. Is that when I was working in when I was getting my degree in geology, there was a whole bunch of positions listed everywhere. But then the moment I actually got my degree, it became a problem of like every single position. Suddenly, you had to be local. They were not willing to move you for the position, and you need to have several degrees of experience and management experience, and possibly also a master's or PhD on top of that. And so, like, literally, like, every single element of the job made it the entire job market completely impermeable all of a sudden. And I'm like, how do you guys realize that at some point, like, you need new people coming in, or you're all going to be 60 years old and dead?
I think when the baby boomers retire, things are going to look up. I know that a lot of teaching positions have gone out. I mean, I'm not a teacher in any ways, but my mom certifies them. So she's like, yeah, there's a lot of people retiring. And it's like, whoa.
Yeah. Well, I also feel like 2008 made everybody scared of, like, taking risks with their business, so they'd rather overwork the hell out of their, like, current base and only pull on, like, the best of the best at minimum prices and effectively scarcifying the job market for security.
Well, I think the thing is, too, people are so expendable now. They can hire replacement in an instant.
They've always been... Oh, yeah.
Jemani had a sci-fi sequel. Or Jim, the comment says, Jemani had a sci-fi squeal.
Oh, are they talking about, like,
I assume they mean Jumanji and sci-fi sequel. Yeah, I was thinking Zathura.
I
don't think Zathura is an actual sequel, though. I think it's just a it's a shameless concept stealing thing.
Yeah.
Yes.
Like how Dark City is a fantastic sci-fi movie whose idea is completely ripped from up by the roots by a adjustment bureau.
Oh really?
Yeah,
because I've seen Dark
Adjustment
City,
Bureau
but
is just a copy of it's a shitty copy of a good movie.
Well, I suppose I'll have to see the Adjustment Bureau then, because I've seen Dark City.
I just told you that's the bad one.
Oh, Adjustment Bureau is the bad one. Okay,
yes.
Okay.
Adjustment Bureau came out a few
Dark
years
City
ago.
First.
Dark City is from the 80s and fantastic.
Okay, no. So Dark City is the one that I've seen that I thought was really good.
Yeah.
Yeah. I was just surprised. I'm like, wait, Dark City is the copy?
No,
can't be right.
Adjustment Bureau is a shitty, like, Matt Damon movie, I think, where, like, for some reason, guys in hats that look like the sci-fi things from Fringe are, like, trying to secretly control society and keep these two characters from loving each other for some reason. They were like, Dark City is a freaky thing where it was aliens, I think, trying to define humanity and get to the essence of why humans matter. By continually shifting and rearranging their society at night to keep running tests,
basically.
And
erasing their memories or, like, fabricating them.
Yeah, you'd literally you'd go to sleep one night and wake up as a different person with different memories of a completely different life and a different lifestyle and a different location.
But, of course, this one guy had the cycle broken, so...
Well, yeah, because I think they had a system that would make everyone fall asleep, and he specifically managed to stay awake during it, and so he just witnessed them changing society around him, and it's like, what the fuck?
And then they had those, like, creepy hunters that would come out and try to bring you down.
Where's Red Saber? I cannot find my last Red Saber.
Yeah, that last area kind of sucks for, like, getting around.
I just
need
one more.
Okay, I need to find Cobra Fangs and long neck razors, a.k.a. giraffes, maybe? I'll have to see what
also,
they look like.
I read it wrong. Bird is very sick.
Yeah.
So, there was no chance of Borderlands anyway. So,
you lied to us. You lied to us all.
I was trying to read short bursts of bird speak combo combined with you guys speaking in the background. I'm just like, think I'm getting this? No, I'm not getting this.
I need to target something first. I need a target.
Oop.
You know the nice thing about not giving a damn about gathering materials? My inventory is very empty.
Yeah.
These
I've
look like
probably
a cross
wasted a lot of money here.
Giraffes and Ikabi.
Where the hell is Dread Saber, damn it?
And the I've jobs seen... overseas. that stopped for the most part, like as an industry trend. Because they realized it was like super bad. It depends.
No,
but like,
unless you're a tech support company.
Lucasfilm came to our school and we're like, hey, where are the art internships? And they're like, they're in Singapore.
Yeah. So if you're talking about Singapore, yeah, they do pay the Singaporeans less. But like the Singaporean like art program is actually really good. Like I was looking at it, I was like, I should have gone to college in Singapore.
Yeah, I know. It's just that they're sort of outsourcing all their animation and stuff over there, though.
Yeah, well, like I said, they're like, art education is actually pretty top-notch. And also, they get paid less, so.
I hear that Singapore is, like, a really clean, cultured country. Like, they don't allow smoking, gum. Yep. I mean, chewing gum.
Are you guys going for the long neck grazers, or are you still looking for the dread sabers?
I can't find one last red saber.
I just killed a dread saber.
I'm standing next to one.
God damn it. You're so far away.
There are plenty right around here.
Tough cookie, banana man.
One of these days. Quest. One of these days. Oh, here's one.
Died, red saber.
I have to do that one.
There we go.
Yeah.
Just in time, it's like, I finally found one. Well, fuck you, here's a billion of them. I literally killed that guy, and around the corner was another one immediately. After running around for like 10 minutes, I think.
Don't believe we stopped, that we finished. Like, we can't outsource anymore. No, so, I'm speaking specifically from industries that I'm used to. Game dev outsourcing is like dropped, stopped, and like turned around. And it's actually like a bad thing in India.
Oh yeah, because they realized it was really easy to just abuse American workers.
Yes. That's also true. Like,
oh, yeah,
QA
it sucks to be a game developer
like
in the United States. That's why I kind of pulled out of going that career path, because I originally was trying to.
It's a complete lottery. Like, either sucks or it's completely awesome. Really depends on what company you're working for.
Unfortunately, a pretty big percentage of jobs in the United States for game dev involve working huge hours, and how, like, entire development cycles sometimes are just entirely crunch time, not seeing your family, getting paid way less than anyone else with the same skill set does in any other part of the field. Like, if you take your programming experience or your design experience and just don't do games, you get way more money for doing the same kind of work, but with better hours and better benefits, because they're not like, because the people for game devs are all like, but you're doing a passion project as an excuse for treating you shitty. And treating it all like crap.
Oh man!
And then on top of that, like every time you finish a project, everyone gets fired.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's like you have to go find a new job from scratch. You have to job search every few freaking years. I'm like, nope. I'm gonna do geology. And then that turned out to be a nightmare too. I tried.
Did I ever tell you about when I was starting YouTube? I got a number of like developers showing up on my channel and like my email and stuff, asking if I want to do the art for their video games. Did I ever mention that, or no, not really?
I think so. Like, didn't they want you to do it for free, basically? Because it's like experience, or like a hobby?
Notoriety!
Yeah.
Yeah,
so
we'll
like,
give you
contacted.
Exposure!
I got contacted by one guy while I was streaming artwork for a job application, actually, for, I was doing an art test, which, now that I think about it, also sucked really hard, and that's why I don't play Brawlhalla.
I have not seen a single grazer yet.
Wait, but they actually, like,
there
did Skype interviews and everything with you.
They did. I made it to the very end, but it's still annoying that I'd spent, like, you know, a good
They didn't even send you a rejection. Yeah,
and
I
never
know.
Even said no. They're just like, okay, that's
you were trying to work on Brawlhalla, right?
Oh, yeah. I need to get this quest sucks. We should probably not do it. Maybe come back later.
Well, this was back when he was
Guys,
still wanting to.
Let's not do long neck grazers. Let's go do something else, like intact cobra fangs.
Oh.
But what if we're missing like an entire? Maybe there's a whole field of them that we're missing.
I just encountered
are,
a number
cool.
of them.
And they're all dead. We're also competing with people, but the drop rate isn't good.
So on top of finding
the
them in the first place, the drop rate sucks.
Yeah.
Oh no.
And they also get killed by the dread sabers around. So I'm
gonna
go fight cobras instead.
That seems to be really bad in particular, the dread saber part. Because I just literally can't see them anywhere. I just saw my first live one so far. Got my stick immediately. But
you gotta get five of them.
Yeah, I haven't seen any other live ones this whole time.
Yeah, here, come join me with cobras. There's a fuck ton of cobras and crocolisks in the same area.
Okay.
And, the drop rate seems much higher.
No! No! Die! Fuck you, Saber!
Did it kill it?
I intercepted it. Just barely. Oh, now they're showing up a bit. Yeah, that's pretty fucked up that they're only spawned in one tiny zone and they're kind of rare, and then the local NPCs will also kill them.
Good stuff.
Why would you do that? Wow.
But yeah, so I was streaming artwork for an art test for the Brawlhalla folks. And, you know, all fine and good and whatever. But another guy shows up and, like, more or less starts kind of talking glowingly about his idea for his game or whatnot. And some people in my chat rip him to shreds and he gets all huffy about it. And so I ask him, you know, hey, you know, what details do you have for me? And he sends me this, like, poorly written kind of copy-pasta email that he probably sent to a bunch of other artists talking about, like, his idea effectively. And it's just like, oh.
Yeah, he's just trying to get labor out of people.
Yes.
Yay. But,
because everybody sees art as, like, even less work than, like, being a programmer at a video game, you know, labor and love and whatnot.
When they're both super fucking hard and specialized skills that people had to work on forever to get and still are hard to do in the action of doing it.
Yes. But so, like, I get a lot of emails about exposure or experience or because it's fun, and it's like, you know what's fun? Working on my own shit. You know what's not fun? Working on your shit.
You know what's fun? Eating under a roof.
Yes. Yes.
Asshole.
Being able to pay bills. But so, once I asked the lead on my program in college if he got a bunch of these emails, and he's like, oh yeah, I get so many of them. We were in Kuroshi, who's drunk, and he just pulled out his phone and just started flipping through just hundreds of emails that he gotten over the years, because he just sorted them all into a box for people asking, emailing the program, asking people for artists as like a
student artists.
Yeah, that they could, you know, work for experience or whatever on their children's books, their video games, their, you know, charity campaign, whatever. It's like, you know, if you want to do this yourself and find it, sure. But I'm not going to be, a resource for somebody to scam, my students out of, you know, their time and effort.
Yeah, that's all problematic.
Yeah.
This is bad. There we go.
Have you heard about the Baldur's Gate expansion?
Oh, the transgender thing?
Or even just the news that they made an expansion to a game 15 years later.
Well, they always had plans for it, but they never did because time and money and they were too busy with other stuff. So like, I don't know. I think it's cool that they created an expansion years later, but honestly, I would have rather like a remake using a much better game system because Baldur's Gate, they just remade it, didn't they? Sort of. It's just the enhanced edition, which functions a little bit better, but that's the extent of it.
I mean, remaking it again would be dumb. At that point, just make a new Baldur's Gate, but that supposedly is what they were trying to do. Supposedly, they were working on this expansion to try to prove that they could get away with making a new one altogether.
Yeah, I guess it makes sense.
Like,
I mean,
because
the
they want to make Baldur's Gate 3.
Pillars of Eternity and Divinity Original Sin already proved that CRPGs are still popular. You just have to make a good one. But the controversy is that they put in, like, a transgendered character or something, wasn't it?
Yeah, people do get mad about that.
I mean, to be fair, it makes no sense to me that there would be a transgendered character when there's literally a belt that changes your sex in the game.
Yeah.
That my brother snuck onto my character when I wasn't looking, and I was frustrated about it because I was, like, 12
like,
and cooties.
Like the coffin from Dark Souls 2.
I don't think I know that one.
You don't know about that? In Dark Souls 2, at the very beginning of the game, where
there's that place of the ogres.
Yeah, if you sleep in that coffin, it turns you into a woman, or vice versa.
Yeah.
And doesn't tell
Bert
you.
Bert and I did that at the very end of our series, and we looked horrifying.
I played, like, amazing. A big chunk of my original playthrough of Dark Souls 2 as the other gender without knowing. Because you wouldn't notice, because you're in armor. So, like, you just have you die and hear the, oh! And you're like, oh, wait, that doesn't sound right. Your death sound didn't quite sound right, but that was your only clue.
It would be a little mind-boggling for me to play that DLC and see that there is a transgendered character when you literally can magically change a gender. And, like, I don't care beyond that. I don't...
If a game is so fluid and silly already, then that makes it silly to make take anything too seriously.
Yeah, it's true.
Which makes controversy kind of silly inherently.
I have fallen into a puddle.
If you have controversy about the contents of a game are, it's a little silly if the game itself is already loose with its own canon,
like,
or whatever.
I could see somebody being annoyed at like the portrayal of women in like, oh god. Like I could see why people would be annoyed.
That one's
pretty bad. That's when it gets creepy. The whole quiet outfit thing. Yeah. Like, it's just weird.
At least the character acknowledged that her outfit was weird. She's like, what is this? Why? But then it's just like, wait, so I'm just imagining the developers snickering as they, you know, put her in that. And then they're like, we'll make her Paul.
No, I can totally just see, like, the art director is kind of this, like, skeezy dude. And it's like, no, less close.
And what's a bummer is that there's conversations about, like, people saying that the writing in the new expansion sucks, basically. But all that's overshadowed by just people talking about the transgender stuff over and over and over again. To the point where people who try to cite that the writing is bad only use that specific thing as an example over and over again. It's like, well, I don't know the context of that line, and context is everything in how these games are written in general. But also, more than one line should be bad if the writing's bad, but no one is smart enough to cite more than that in their articles or their complaints.
Yeah, which reminds me about like the whole like Tube House thing. You know, we're considering cheaper locations, but you know, still had good internet, tech industry potentially there for like our jobs and whatever. And so we had considered, you know, places like Raleigh or the, you know, Research Triangle down North Carolina. But you know, North Carolina having passed that ludicrous bill, essentially discriminating against transgender people from using their bathroom of choice, whatnot. Now there are so many companies that are threatening to pull out, have pulled out, or are just saying that they're not going to have any dealings or send any of their employees or representatives to the state anymore. And it's like, this was such a good candidate, but now I'm not so sure. Because... Are you guys still there?
Yeah.
Yep.
I mean,
you also can't even suggest the belt or a spell to the person. That's a bit of a shame. Like, it would be neat if you could just, like, give them the belt and it's like, oh, as, like, a kind of Divinity Original Sin style secret ending to a quest, like the dumb shit that we'd always do.
Yeah, that's weird that item just kind of breaks their little story, doesn't it?
Yeah. Like, I understand trying to be, like, modern and,
if anything,
like, relevant.
It's adding that kind of stuff is redundant when the belt exists, because then the belt itself already exists as kind of a statement.
Yes.
Weird.
Well.
Makes me think of a game like, I think it was Maximum Overdrive? Sunset Overdrive, I believe, is a game where you can casually redesign your character whenever you feel like it, including changing their gender, and it'll just continue with the story as if nothing changed. It's like you could just like do every mission as a different gender, cause fuck it.
Finally got another fang.
Which is just kind of amusing.
Add some extra genders in there for good measure. Why not?
You want a game with equal representation? Freaking the later Saints Row games are just like, fuck it, nothing matters anymore.
Speaking of, like, non-genders and stuff, you know,
you can be an overweight African-American superhero woman.
You can have sex with a robot. Why not?
I just pulled an adventurous dwarf out of this tree.
Yes. Watch where you're tugging.
Gross. Got his banana. Got his banana. Jesus.
I got papaya. That presents questions.
does the banana not? I think there's a lot of questions.
Where is he keeping the papaya? That's the question.
does the papaya signify something that I don't know about?
That's the question.
The papaya. I'm trying to think of what a papaya looks like. First thought was Durango, which sounds... I mean, not a durian, which sounds super painful.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. I think I heard about that once, that somebody was, like, doing something with durian, and I'm like...
Wait, what's durian?
I don't want...
A durian is a fruit that looks like a spike ball, and when you open it, it smells like shit. Like, actually shit. Like, literally shit.
For some reason, I was thinking of the DeLorean.
No, you've seen them. We walk by them whenever we go to the Korean grocery store.
Those little orange things?
No. They look like massive...
They're huge.
...sort of coconuts, but they're like very...
They're like coconut pineapples.
Yeah. And they're like... They're hard and spiky and...
Okay.
Huge, like size of my head huge.
They look fake.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm gonna stick with you, because... Whenever you kill something, I get a fang for it.
You guys are still on that quest?
I'm not getting fangs at all. It's driving me insane.
Wow. I got them, like,
I get fangs.
Yeah, that's how RNG works, Wander. Congratulations, you figured it out.
It's just interesting that we'd have such a varied...
It's happened every time now, though, hasn't
warrior.
It?
Yeah, it's true. I mean, I did finish that one other quest... Start to finish. Oh, there we go.
Yeah, you got zero result for that one quest the entire time I was doing it. Then when I got to four, you got all five of yours before I got my fifth one.
I think it was, like, literally just, like, one, two, three, four.
Yeah. RNG is kind of a pain in the ass.
Sorry.
At least they started adding modifiers to it, like, they have to be intact, as opposed to original WoW was like, they need to have a kidney. It's like, oh, none of these animals have kidneys! What do we do? They should have, like, two each.